it's wonderful to have you guys back here in town. So, so it's also nice to have you back on the, you know, the Panic Over North America tour. So, I know that you guys have, you know, in the past done, like, you know, petition your fans to get input for set lists, etc. Did you do that this go around, or?
No, we did not. We kind of wanted to try out the new songs to see if we, you know, how the reaction of the crowd would be, you know, and, you know, it's getting harder and harder to do a set list every time because now we have, you know, 8 records.
Right.
It's a lot of stuff to actually have to sift through. So, you know, I think we have a great set list. I mean, it's kind of, we're playing all the hits and a couple of, like, of the older songs that we feel like the crowd has been very, you know, responsive to.
That's awesome. So how does it feel to actually be able to, you know, play the new songs, et cetera? Is it starting to feel a little bit more comfortable?
It is, yeah. It is. I mean, the new record is by far the most technical one, so it's kind of,
yes,
it's definitely, you know, it's a challenge, but we're having a lot of fun. I mean, it's a lot of fun to play the songs live, you know. First couple of days was a little, you know, you kind of have to stand still a little bit, you know, because they're, you know, make sure they can do everything properly. But now it's starting to get better and better.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Speaking of the new album, it's probably, you know, the best and most pissed off and melodic and unique that you guys have done since, like, Natural Born Chaos, and as well as Bigger Number 5. So,
awesome
music. And also, congrats on standing so high.
Yeah.
Getting 88, so you surpassed your last Standing Mama, so congrats.
Thank you. That's incredible for us, considering the fact that, you know, record sales have gone down and this one's actually scanning more than the Stabbing. We're ecstatic about it.
And who's saying kids don't buy records anymore?
Yeah, right? Yeah.
That's pretty cool. So you guys also have, like, a bit of bonus DVD material on the mm-hmm. album as well?
Yes.
So are you, like, planning on releasing, like, kind of a full length or, you know, DVD
yeah.
some point in time soon?
Yes, we are.
Are you using this tour as well to kind of gather more material?
Well, it depends on how we're actually going to do a DVD. We're still talking about what that DVD should actually, what should be on it.
Okay.
And I think what we're going to try and do is we want to do this, we want to do like a 2-day, we want to record like a show 2 days in a row. And have like a full camera team in there, but then also have like, you know, camera crew following like the whole aspect of like, building up to show, like, what we do, like, when you guys don't see it, you know, kind of...
Behind the scenes.
Yeah, behind the scenes, you know, but just, like, pre-production, what goes into it, and,
okay.
you know, and this, I think that would be kind of an interesting aspect of, for fans to see, like, just to see all the kind of work that goes into the show, instead
that's
of just coming there and you know, kind of start, so... But I think that's what we're going to try and do, we just have to figure out where we're going to do it.
So, what does the Panic broadcast mean to you?
Well, for me, it's a record that I hold very close to my heart. You know, I was away for 3 years, and I actually had no intention of coming back, mainly because, you know, I felt like I was burnt out on touring, and after we did Stabbing, I just had a hard time seeing, like, where Soilwork was going to go musically. So, for me, that was the first time in my career that I didn't know what kind of direction we were supposed to take, you know, and I wasn't really feeling the... You know, I'm not saying that I wasn't feeling that old, but I kind of felt like I was pigeonholed, you know, because I was part of Soilwork from the very beginning. And I had always, you know, tried to do side projects, but it never happened because I was a girl. Thanks for the same. And basically, I think... I wanted to do something that was different, you know. I wanted to do music production because I've always wanted to do that. And basically, I did that, and I also was able to do a lot of other projects that would, you know, make me evolve as a songwriter, I think. And because I did that, I felt like I had a better idea of where solo should be going, like, once they asked me to come back. And I was like, okay, well, I think I have a good idea of where I think the band should go. So.
Do you kind of think the writing was on the wall, you know, with Stabbing the Drama and with the creative process of it, or, you know, were you kind of feeling the burnout during that time, or did it, like, happen afterwards?
Not so much. I think it kind of happened during the recording process. You know, and I was, you know, I just got married, or I was about to get married, actually, and, you know, I was doing the whole long-distance relationship because my wife was here, and I was in Sweden, and it was kind of tough, and I guess it was a very stressful time for me when it comes to touring and, you know, trying to make everything work, but
that's what I can imagine with that.
Yeah. I mean, it was a stressful time, but you know, I think Stabbing turned out great. I'm still really proud of that record. But the new one is really, we like everything that Bjorn, like, I think that we tried to capture like raw emotion on this one, Bjorn, for example, which I think that we were able to do. And we also, like, we didn't really want to, we kind of wrote material without thinking like, okay, what the consequences are going to be, you know, as far as like, is it going to be too different for the record, or, you know, we just, you know, screw this, we're going to write whatever we want, and if people like it, they like it, if they don't like it, then that's it. But I think that, now I think that proves to us that, you know, if we write from our hearts and we really feel it, as opposed to thinking like what's going to work with the fans, I think that now we notice that, you know, people appreciate that more. And that's the truth.
Well, that's what music's about. It's about emotions.
Right, you know? Right. But it's very easy to get, you know, fall into this category where you have management and label always kind of trying to direct you in a certain direction. And we broke free from that. And we said, you know, we just want to do what we want to do. You know, so we're kind of grateful that we got to do this whole thing by ourselves. You know?
Which is awesome. Because I can imagine it can only be kind of hard for you to, you know, have such a legacy. And for you to try to live up to that, and like you said, you kind of like pigeonhole yourself or something.
Right.
So it's not like you have, like, I guess, the freedom to go, oh, we're going to do this now. You know, and
right.
Then you have a fear of your fans maybe not following you, etc. So.
Yeah. I mean, that's, you can't always do the same record, you know, because I think as an artist or, you know, a musician, it's kind of, you know, as much as the fans wants to hear you do that record that you've already done, it's not really, I don't think they really do, you know, because they're always going to compare that.